Welcome to e-learning course on Applied Thermodynamics, Module Refrigeration Cycles, Session Introduction to Refrigeration Cycles and Reversed Carnot Cycle. Myself Ramesh B.R., Assistant Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, Jain Institute of Technology, Davangere. Refrigeration. It is defined as the process of reducing and maintaining the temperature of space or substance below the temperature of its surroundings or atmosphere by continuously removing heat of the space or substance by means of external work input. The machine or device used to produce refrigeration effect is called refrigerating machine or refrigerator, and the working substance used in the refrigeration cycle is called refrigerant. In refrigeration, heat is continuously extracted from the given space or substance by performing mechanical work and rejecting this heat to the surrounding atmosphere. This is achieved by means of a working medium known as refrigerant. The refrigerant is a chemical substance and includes ammonia, carbon dioxide, methyl chloride, freon, etc. The refrigerant in the liquid state is made to circulate in a cycle through a series of events where it undergoes a change of phase from liquid to vapor and again back to the liquid state. In its liquid state, the refrigerant absorbs heat from the given substance and changes to vapor phase, and in turn this heat is rejected to the surroundings by condensing back to liquid phase. The process repeats again and again, thereby maintaining low temperatures in the given space or substance. There are many uses of refrigeration. Major areas include storage of fruits, vegetables, fish, meat, dairy products, ice manufacturing, preservation of medicines and chemicals, air conditioning, and industries like petroleum refineries, printing, textile and paper pulp factories, for efficient and manufacturing processing. Refrigerant, a substance which absorbs heat and undergoes phase change, is called a refrigerant. It is a working fluid used in the refrigerator. Now we discuss some of the important properties of a good or ideal refrigerant. We can identify some of the categories of properties as thermodynamic properties, chemical properties, physical properties, and other types of properties. The first category identified here is a thermodynamic properties. In that, the first one is low boiling point. A good refrigerant should have a boiling point below the target temperature, since boiling point is affected by pressure. Refrigerants should be selected based on the operating pressures. Next is low freezing point. Here the liquid refrigerant must not solidify under a specified pressure. The third one is positive pressure in condenser and evaporator, then high saturation temperature so that heat transfer can occur with least possible circulating refrigerant, high latent heat of vaporization and high critical temperature. Next is chemical properties. In that, the first one is non-toxic, the second one is non-flammable and non-explosive to avoid risk of fire and explosion, non-corrosive so that the refrigerant does not corrode the machine components, chemically stable so that it does not disassociate or break down. The refrigerant has to be stable for the lifetime of the refrigerator and no effect on the quality of substance stored. And next is non-irritating and odorless. The physical properties are, the first one is low specific volume of vapor so that it occupies minimum space, thereby keeping the compressor capacity to a minimum and pipe diameter relatively small. Low specific heat is the second physical property. The third is high thermal conductivity so that heat transfer takes place easily. Low viscosity for easy circulation of the refrigerant. High electrical insulation. And then some of the other properties are ease of leakage location. So, in case of any leakages, there should be ease in identifying the leakage of a refrigerant. Then the availability and low cost, it should be easily available and the cost should be low. Ease of handling, the refrigerant should be easily handled. And high coefficient of performance. And the last one is low power consumption. So, the consumption of power by the refrigeration cycle should be low. So, these are some other properties with respect to good or ideal refrigerants. So, moving on to next one, some of the important terms which are used in the refrigeration cycle. So, in that, the first one is refrigerating effect, the second one is coefficient of performance, next one is relative COP and the last one is ice making capacity. So, we see one by one what is first one, that is refrigerating effect. So, it is the amount of heat removed per unit time from the space to be cooled by the refrigeration process. It is expressed in terms of ton of refrigeration. The amount of cooling produced by the refrigeration process is called as refrigerating effect. In other words, it can also be defined that it is a rate of heat removed per unit time, and the unit of refrigerating effect is kilojoules per second or kilowatt, that is, it can also be expressed in the form of ton of refrigeration. Sometimes refrigerating effect is also called as capacity of refrigerator. So, one of the unit of refrigerating effect is ton of refrigeration and it is defined as the quantity of heat absorbed in order to form 1 ton of ice in 24 hours when the initial temperature of water is 0 degree Celsius. And in SI unit, 1 ton of refrigeration is equal to 210 kilojoules per minute or 3.5 kilowatt. It is important to note that a ton of refrigeration is a measurement of the rate of heat transfer and not a unit of mass. That is, 1 ton of refrigeration will not produce 1 ton of ice due to the fact that in earlier days refrigeration was produced by ice. The rate of removal of heat in cooling operation was expressed in terms of ton of ice required per unit time, usually in 24 hours. The next one is coefficient of performance. The performance of a refrigerator is measured by a factor known as coefficient of performance, simply termed as COP. The COP is defined as the ratio of the amount of heat removed from a given space to the work supplied for the heat removal. And it is given by COP equal to heat removed over work supplied. Symbolically, we can write heat removed as Q and work supplied as W. And the unit of COP will not be there, as the heat transfer and work are expressed in kilojoules per second or kilowatt, and coefficient of performance is a unitless quantity. COP is the basic parameter used as a measure of energy efficiency of heating or cooling and refrigeration appliances. The higher the COP, the more efficient is the device. To serve the purpose, COP must be always greater than unity. Next is relative COP. It is the ratio of actual COP to theoretical COP. And the last one is ice making capacity. It is the ability of the refrigerating system to make ice starting from water at room temperature. Moving on to the next one, that is refrigerants commonly used in practice. So, these are the few refrigerants like ammonia, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide and freon group. So, these are the few refrigerants commonly used in daily practice. We see one by one. The first one is ammonia. Ammonia is the oldest and widely used of all the refrigerants. It has a normal boiling temperature of -33.3 degrees Celsius and it is soluble in water, produces high refrigeration effect. It is costless and does not harm the ozone layer. At atmospheric pressure, the liquid specific gravity will be around 0.684. It is highly toxic and flammable. It is widely used in large industrial and commercial reciprocating compression systems. However, due to its high toxicity, not miscible with lubricating oil, explosive, moderately flammable, irritating and corrosive. These food destroying properties make it unsuitable for domestic refrigerator. But this type of refrigerant is used where its toxic nature is not considered seriously. It is also widely used as a refrigerant in absorption refrigeration system. Next we see carbon dioxide, the second common type of refrigerant what we can be used in practice. It is a colorless, odorless gas and is heavier than atmospheric air. It is non-toxic, non-flammable, but requires extremely high operating pressure in the range of 70 bar. At atmospheric pressure, it has a normal boiling point of minus 77.6 degrees Celsius and liquid specific gravity of around 1.56. It is nearly 1.53 times heavier than the air and hence requires high operating pressure, thereby lowering the efficiency of the refrigeration. However, due to its low specific volume, the plant size can be made compact to be used in large ships, thereafter air conditioning systems and similar such applications where space consideration is more important. And it is not widely used because of its high power requirement per ton of refrigeration and high operating pressures. The next one is sulfur dioxide. It is a third common type of refrigerant what we'll come across in a refrigeration system. It is a colorless gas or liquid. It is extremely toxic and has a pungent, irritating odor. It is non-explosive and non-flammable. It has a boiling point of minus 10.5 degrees Celsius and a liquid specific gravity of 1.36. It is used in small tonnage commercial units. And the next one is Freon 12, or in general you can say it as a Freon group. So Freon group of refrigerants are highly efficient and overcomes the disadvantages of all the above types of refrigerants. However, these refrigerants were discovered to deplete the ozone layer, thereby making us a search for newer refrigerants. In that, the first Freon is, it is a group in that the Freon 12, it is also represented by R12 symbolically. Freon 12 shortly designated as R12 with a chemical formula CCl2F2, which is dichlorodifluoromethane, is non-flammable, non-explosive, non-corrosive and odorless. It has a normal boiling point of around minus 30 degrees Celsius and operating pressure will be around 8 bars. It is used in small capacity equipments such as domestic refrigerator, water coolers, air conditioners, automobiles, etc. Freon 12 is most widely used out of the entire Freon group. And we have one more type of Freon group, that is Freon 22, which is designated as R22 with a chemical formula of CHClF2, which is chlorodifluoromethane. And it has a similar properties as that of Freon 12. It has a normal boiling point of around minus 40.8 degrees Celsius. That is about 10% less than that of the Freon 12. It is therefore a comparatively a high pressure refrigerant. Freon 22 is employed in large capacity plants like packaged air conditioning units where size of equipment economy are not important. It is also used for low and medium temperature refrigeration. From the year 2010, only recycled or saved stocks of Freon refrigerants can be used. Nowadays, it will not be no longer in manufacturing. Before going further, we will discuss some of the modern refrigerants that is hydrofluorocarbon. Hydrofluorocarbons, which is designated as HFCs, are a family of hydrocarbons containing one or several fluorine atoms but no chlorine atoms, thus have no ozone depleting potentials. Members of this family of compounds possess favorable thermodynamics, health and safety properties to be used as an alternate refrigerant to R12 as well as R22. For example, R134a, known as tetrafluoromethane, chemical name is CH2FCF3, and is a hydrofluorocarbon compound with no chlorine content. It is non-corrosive, non-toxic and non-flammable. It has a normal boiling point of minus 15 degree Celsius, 15 degree Celsius. It is identified as a replacement for R12 refrigerant, and R134a, which is a modern refrigerant, is used for medium temperature applications such as air conditioning and commercial refrigeration. The refrigerant is widely used in modern car air conditioners are R134a. Other refrigerants of hydrofluorocarbon compound include R407C, R410A, etc. And this is all about the different types of refrigerants commonly used in practice. Moving on to next one, which is a reversed heat engine cycle or a reversed Carnot cycle. We make use of a block diagram as displayed on the screen. You have total three diagrams. The first diagram represents a heat engine working between two source, heat source. One is heat source at high temperature, another is heat source which is at low temperature. So, in simple name, we can call it as source and sink. So, heat is drawn from the source, work is produced by the reversible heat engine, which is equal to W, and heat is rejected to a temperature of T2 sink. And now the reversible heat engine is reversed to work in opposite direction. So, the refrigerators and heat pumps are reversed heat engines. The adjective reversed means operating backward. The direction of heat and work interactions is opposite to that of the heat engine. You can observe with the first block diagram. These machines are used to remove heat from a body at low temperature and then transfer to another body which is at high temperature. When the main purpose of the machine is to remove heat from the low temperature body, so we will call it as a refrigeration. If the purpose of heat supplied to the high temperature body, then we will call it as a heat pump. The transfer of heat against a reverse temperature gradient in a refrigerator and heat pump is accomplished by energy supplied to the machine. The performance of refrigerators and heat pumps is expressed in the terms of coefficient of performance, which is represented by the ratio of desired effect to work input. In refrigerators, the desired effect is the amount of heat extracted from the low temperature body. So, we can write COP of a refrigerator as heat extracted at low temperature to work input. Heat extracted is Q2 and work input is W for a refrigerator. So, symbolically we can write COP of refrigerant as Q2 over W. Now, applying first law of thermodynamics to heat engine which undergoes a cycle gives work is equal to Q1 minus Q2. Now, we are going to replace W with Q1 minus Q2. Therefore, the COP of the refrigerant can be written as Q2 over Q1 minus Q2. For the most of the refrigerating machines, the value of COP lies between 3 and 4, and COP are greatest when temperature difference is least. And we are going to concentrate only on the refrigerator part, as we are going to deal refrigeration cycle in this session. Moving on to the next one, that is refrigeration system, which is working on reversed Carnot cycle principle, and the working substance used is air. We have different types of refrigeration systems. So the first one is air refrigeration, the second can be a vapor compression refrigeration system, the third one is vapor absorption refrigeration system, and the last one is steam jet refrigeration. These are the different types what we can have. So in this session we will discuss about air refrigeration system. So that the line diagram, TS diagram and PV diagram is going to be used to understand what is a air refrigeration system. In air refrigeration system, air is used as a refrigerant. Since air is cheaper, easily available, no danger of fire and toxic effects due to leakage, and also total weight of the refrigeration system per ton of refrigeration being less. It was widely used in commercial applications in olden days. However, air does not change its phase during expansion and compression. That is, it remains gaseous throughout the working cycle. Therefore, its heat carrying capacity per kg of air is very small compared to other refrigeration systems. This drawback made the system practically obsolete. However, today again finds its application in aircraft refrigeration due to its low weight and volume requirement of the equipment. Air refrigeration system works on two cycles. One is reversed Carnot cycle, another one is reversed Brayton cycle, which is also called as Bell-Coleman cycle. In this session, we will discuss about a air refrigeration system working on reversed Carnot cycle. In reversed Carnot cycle, the refrigerant is first compressed reversibly and adiabatically in the process 1 to 2. This is from 1 to 2 adiabatically, where the work input per kg of refrigerant, which is WC, is given. Then it is condensed reversibly in the process 2 to 3, from 2 to 3 condensed reversibly, where the heat rejection Q1 takes place. Heat is rejected, which is equal to Q1. The refrigerant then expands reversibly and adiabatically from the process 3 to 4, where the work output is WE. And finally, it absorbs heat Q2 reversibly by the evaporation from the surrounding from process 4 to 1, as you can observe in your PV diagram as well as TS diagram. The process 1 to 2 is the first process. Refrigerant is compressed reversibly and adiabatically. The process 2 to 3 is condensed reversibly, where heat rejection takes place. And process 3 to 4, the refrigerant expands reversibly and adiabatically. And the last process 4 to 1, finally it absorbs heat Q2 reversibly by evaporation from the surrounding. So this is how a air refrigeration system on reverse cycle is going to work. So now we are going to obtain the expression for coefficient of performance for a air refrigeration system working on reversed Carnot cycle. Here we know Q1, which is equal to T1 into S2 minus S3 from your TS diagram. So Q1 represents heat rejected during condensation process from point 2 to point 3. So initial entropy is taken as S2, final entropy is S3, and heat rejection is taken as Q1. So Q1 is equal to T1 into, it is written as initial minus final, to avoid negative sign here. And Q2 is equal to, which is heat drawn from the space to be cooled, that is Q2, or heat which is drawn from the low temperature body, is equal to T2. So the temperature of this line is T2, and it is written as difference in entropy as S1 minus S4. So final state is 1 and the initial state is 4. So it is written as S1 minus S4. So these are the two things what we can observe from the TS diagram. Now net work done can be written as work done by the compression process minus work done by the expansion process, which is equal to Q1 minus Q2, and we are going to substitute for Q1 and Q2 from these two expressions, and finally we will get T1 minus T2 multiplied with S1 minus S4 after simplification, where T1 is the temperature of heat rejection and T2 is the temperature of heat absorption. Therefore, COP of refrigeration is given by heat extracted at low temperature over work input. So what is the heat extracted at low temperature? It is equal to Q2. So Q2 is equal to T2 S1 minus S4, and work input is, that is T1 minus T2 into S1 minus S4. So now we are going to substitute for work input as this, and after simplification we will finally come across COP of refrigerant is equal to T2 over T1 minus T2, and this is the expression of coefficient of performance of a air refrigeration system working on Carnot cycle, that is reversed Carnot cycle. And this is the end of session on introduction to the refrigeration cycle and reversed Carnot cycle. Thank you so much. Please do subscribe to my channel BR Mech Academy.